So, in previous sessions, we have seen how to convert a polar form into the Cartesian and Cartesian coordinates into polar, algebraic into polar equation and polar equation back to algebraic equations. And we have seen the case of minus r, theta, which can be written as r, pi plus theta.
No.
Now, in this session, we are going to see basically angle between radius, vector and tangent. And guy, I tell you this is denoted by phi, and I tell you this concept, angle between radius, vector and tangent, is applicable in upcoming three sessions. See, this thing and angle between the curves also is this concept only, nothing new concept will be there. And in pedal equation also, we have been hardcore using this radius, vector and tangent thing to find that angle phi. So this is a very important, I will give more stress, I will solve more number of questions on this, so that it can be beneficial in upcoming sessions to you. So I am alerting you, I am warning you, please give a stress on this topic, because it will be containing this angle between radius, vector and tangent. This next thing which we are going to see is angle between the curves, also the same concept. And third, that is your pedal equation, the same concept we are going to see. Okay, later on we will change into curvature and radius of curvature, somehow the different things there. But upcoming three session will hardcore depend on this. Is it okay? So angle between the radius, vector and tangent vector, let's first see what is it. Let's see the proof of it first. Okay, so this thing will consist of proof. Let's see proof. Okay. Now what else is given to you? Let's draw first. So this is x, this is y. So let's say your curve is something like this. R as a function of f of theta. And let's say this P is nothing but r, theta. You have been given a curve. You have been given a curve which is r is f as a function of theta. Is it okay? Now this is O, this is P thing. So this is called as your radius vector. This is theta. Now tangent at point P will be like this. If I draw, okay, sorry. It will be like this, okay. So basically what I need to find, angle between this radius vector and the tangent. Basically I need to find this angle which I am calling as phi. So phi is basically the angle between radius vector and that r and tangent. Okay. Is it okay? Now, you know that if curve is given, y is a function of x. So tangent at any point P can be written as tan theta, where theta is a angle made by that is slope of tangent, which can be written as dy by dx. You know this? For example, I have something curve. So you find this theta in that case, and you write tan theta, which is nothing but, it is nothing but what? It is the what? Slope. Sorry, not slope. Oh, sorry. It is an angle made by tangent. Is it okay? And tan theta, or you write it, if you know the derivative of it, you divide by dx and you put that point P on it, on which I need to find the tangent. You do like this or not? Similar concept we are going to use here. Okay. So I am taking this angle as phi. So let's say this point is OPR. Let's say this thing R. So let's start with the proof. In triangle OPR, in triangle OP and R, can I apply exterior angle property? And I write according to exterior angle property phi, that is slope of this tangent, can be written as theta plus phi. Check it. Can I write this? Now applying tan both the side, Can I write tan phi is equals to tan of theta plus phi? Now, if I apply a concept of tan A plus B, can I write it tan phi is equals to tan A plus tan B 1 minus tan A tan B? Let's store this result as 1. Okay, I'm thinking it is clear. What is theta? Is the angle made by the radius vector. Phi is the angle between radius and the tangent. And this sine, it is nothing but the slope of this tangent. Okay, angle made by this tangent, and tan phi is basically denoting the slope. Okay, so this, from this exterior angle property, phi is equals to theta plus phi. I applied tan both the side, I got tan phi is equals to tan theta plus phi, and I got this result. Okay, now one more thing I know from this, as if you remember, r square is equals to x square plus y square also, and x is r cos theta and y is r sin theta. If you remember this, can I write this r as, if it is r comma theta, this is x comma y also same point, so this is x, this is y. Can I write as r, x as r cos theta and y as r sin theta? Now we have stored this result in 1. Okay, we will using this result at the end. Okay, so the second part of the proof says, we know that x is equals to r cos theta, and we know that y is equals to r sin theta, and we have a result stored with us as tan psi is equals to tan theta plus tan phi 1 minus tan theta tan phi. Now differentiate this thing with respect to d theta. So I think you will get dx by d theta is equals to dr by d theta cos theta minus r of sin theta. If I differentiate this equation with respect to d theta, I think you will get this. No? Now again, this also you have to differentiate. You got dy by d theta, differentiation of r will be dr by d theta sin theta plus r of cos of theta. Because you know the differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta, and we know differentiation of sin theta is nothing but cos theta. Is it okay? So same concept we have applied. Now I want to get dy by dx. So what I should go, if I mark it as second, because this was our first result, and as third, so you divide 2 divided by 3, you will get dy by dx, which is nothing but, it will be a form of dr by d theta sin theta plus r of cos theta divided by dr by d theta cos theta minus r of sin theta. Is it? Now if you divide it by d, okay, you do one thing, you divide it by d theta y, or else you divide the, okay, you divide it by dr by d theta cos theta, numerator and denominator. Okay, so when you do this, I think you will get dy by dx. When you divide dr by d theta cos theta, numerator and denominator, what you will get? Here you will get, I think dr by dr is going to cancel out. You will get tan theta plus r d theta by dr, okay, upon dr by d theta cos theta 1 minus r d theta by dr, what else, tan theta. Okay, so what you have done is, we got x as r cos theta, y as r sin theta from our previous knowledge. I have differentiated with respect to d theta here. Now dx by d theta can be written as dr by d theta. First I will differentiate this, then this function, So this will be differentiated, this will remain constant, then this will remain constant, this will be differentiated. No, that thing I have applied, I got dy by dx by dividing this equation by this, I got dr by dt, that is stuff, then I divided numerator and denominator by dr by dt cos theta. So I got this stuff. Let me write this stuff here. So I got this stuff as dy by dx is equals to, I got tan theta plus r d theta by dr upon 1 minus tan theta r d theta by dr. Store it as in fourth. Now, I already started with the concept of tangent, slope of the tangent. I told you that slope of a tangent in our case, the diagram which I drew, is tan phi and can be written as dy by dx. So, if you compare this equation 1 and equation 4, so this tan phi is equals to this dy by dx and this tan theta is tan theta here. But tan phi is your r dr by d theta if you compare. In denominator also tan theta, but tan phi is this. So from comparing 4 and 1, you got tan phi as r d theta by dr. This is the proof. We need phi only, so you can write phi as tan inverse of r d theta by dr also. And this is the proof you have to get. So this is nothing, this phi is what? It is the angle between radius vector and tangent, and it is r d theta by dr. So I will just recall what we have done is, here is, we started with something this. This was theta. If this is the tangent, this was phi. Okay. And this was phi and this psi. So I started with exterior property angle, that phi is equal to theta plus phi. I applied tan both the sides, I got this equation. Then I also know that x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. I got differentiated it and I got this stuff. Then I, here I divided numerator and denominator by dr by d theta cos theta. So I got this equation. Then I have compared this equation. That's it. This is what proof says. So I got nothing but tan phi as r d theta by dr. Is it okay? So the conclusion from this is, the conclusion from of this proof is that angle between, so conclusion from this is the angle between radius and tangent, radius vector and tangent basically, is nothing but phi, and it is tan phi r d theta by dr. See, to solve the questions of angle between radius vector and tangent, I use some kind of trick method, or I use the base, I don't go by the basics, but I have my fixed approach, and I, when I go by that approach, it becomes very easy to solve. So we will see some questions, good questions also on this.